So there was an incident where you had, and we're going to label him today as Azadi. Now, we know the reason why we're labeling this guy as Azadi is because that's terminology that's used by a group of females that have a very anti-black propaganda on social media in relation to the brothers within their own community. They feel that you need to go to a what they call a Zaddy instead of a brother within your community. Now, listen, you date whoever you want to date. I don't care about that. But what I do care about is you using a weaponized propaganda on social media to talk down and act like this group of men is so much better than brothers, and which, you know, that's not even the case. I mean, I don't have to start going down the list on that, what things that their Zaddies have done compared to what have black men have done over hundreds and hundreds of years. But, you know, they're not gonna, those who promote that anti-black propaganda within our community, and understand it's all a hustle and a finesse to get money out of black women that have been hurt in relationships, which is a dangerous propaganda that they're doing. So in this particular story, one of them had dated, I guess, a Zaddy, and this Zaddy had came back to this sister's house, and he left her a message that he wanted her to receive. So let's go ahead and roll that clip.
The family discovers the vulgar vandalism spray painted on a garage door.
It's alarming. It's alarming to the person. It's alarming to the neighborhood because the neighbors don't know what's going on.
Thanks to the family's home surveillance cameras, police quickly developed Ian Grau as a suspect.
It was possibly a person that used to be in a relationship with one of the other family members at the household.
According to investigators, the 22-year-old is an ex-boyfriend of a woman who lives in the home.
They were alarmed when they woke up and saw it. Just the initial shock and then starting to think of, okay, who could have done this? And then they reviewed their security footage.
This is video from later that same day. Police pull over Grau's Mustang.
Hi, it's Officer Gilman Springer. How are you doing?
Good.
Good. We don't want to pull you over. These officers here want to make contact with you. What's your name, buddy?
After positively identifying Grau, police charge him with vandalism, aggravated stalking, and civil rights intimidation.
Obviously, this type of crime will not be tolerated. Everybody deserves the right to live in this country free from any racially motivated incidents.
Because this is considered a potential hate crime, the FBI is also now taking a look at this case.
You see, when things like this happen, those who are pushing that anti-black propaganda and trying to point, you know, black women in our community has been hurt in relationships. And listen, everybody get hurt in relationships. I've been hurt in relationships. It doesn't mean that I start an anti-black propaganda against black women because I've been hurt in relationships in the past. Okay, people get cheated on. People, you know, get married to people and it don't work out. People have children. Sometimes at the breakup of a relationship, the parent is not doing what's right. I've seen that by living long enough from men and women that a parent didn't do right. They got brothers that have their children legal, custody of their children, and the woman just ran off. Don't even pay child support. Don't even be around their children. Just like they got women in our community, they have experienced the same thing. But this weaponized propaganda telling hurt women in our community that it's better to go to a Zaddy because the you know, the messaging is this Zaddy is so much better. He's gonna love you and he's not gonna abuse you. And oh my God, he's just gonna be so much better than that black man, right? But they don't report on stories like this. And the reason why I'm bringing this up, once again, is not because the sister dated this guy. Don't care whatsoever. The problem I have is when you have a weaponized anti-black propaganda against black men or black women. I don't care where it goes, black men or black women, and saying someone else is so much better due to the color of their skin. You literally being a white supremacist yourself. I mean, who they love to hear that kind of propaganda. And they do that as a finesse because they understand that women spend a lot more money than men will. So if they feel that, oh, this particular woman is making me feel confident, and oh, if I can just get me a Zaddy, and if I can just buy this course, if I can buy this book, if I can do this from this particular, these sisters don't care nothing about you. They care about getting their pockets laced. It's a finesse. They don't care because they constantly feed you that anti-black propaganda. And in this time period, anti-black propaganda needs to be called out within the community and also outside the community. It's dangerous. And see, maybe this woman was listening to that propaganda. How do we know? And got with this zaddy and look what he went done. Listen to your black man when it comes to those zaddies of yours you're looking for. We've dealt with them for hundreds of years. We know about his racism. We know how he treats his own woman. Because a lot of times his women will be telling us how he treats her. Don't get me started on the reports I've done of them and with the things they have done. On our African Diaspora News Insider channel, I have a whole series I was doing at one point in time just to shut up some white supremacists about a white-on-white crime series. And I was actively showing them, I don't know how many videos I put up in that series, about showing like, you ain't no better than black folk. You do worse crime than we could ever do. Please, the FBI never show you do. So don't go there like you so much better than black folk. You know, but it's sad what happened. But as brothers, we knew these kind of things that can happen. We know this. We know how disgusting some things they say even about black women. We covered a story last week, an extended part of a story on our website, where you had Jacksonville race soldiers making the most horrible comments ever about black women's genitalia and what they think about it. And these are race soldiers on the job. So how is it you promoting these men as so much better? Like I said, at the end of the day, brothers, I always say, write off anybody in our community who's promoting anti-black propaganda, male or female. Don't entertain them. Don't watch that kind of crowd because it's trash. Don't argue with them because it doesn't make sense. They're lost. They're completely lost. If they want to go out there and be an anti-black bed wench, and yes, I'm using that terminology, bed wench, because those who are considered bed wenches are literally anti-black propagandists and white supremacists themselves. So we need to label them as such. We cannot allow those kind of people to stay within the community in our mix. We can't do that. But leave me a comment. Let me know what you think about the situation with this story. Horrible. I hate to hear this happen, but we got to learn a lesson in everything that we are covering here. Because we don't want, you know, any of our sisters falling prey to an anti-black propaganda thinking they got to get her a zaddy and then something like this happens.